to rights, born and raised. We are thick and thin till our last days. So hold me close and I'll surrender to your heart. You know how to give and how to take. You see every hope I locked away. So pull me close and surrender to my heart before the flame goes out tonight. Yeah, we'll live until we die. So come out, come out, come out. Won't you turn my soul into a raging fire? Come out, come out, come out. Till we lose control into a raging fire. Into a raging fire. Come out, come out, come out. Won't you turn my soul into a and time will take. All the memories made will wash away. Even though we've changed, I'm still here with you. If you listen close, you'll hear the sound of all the ghosts that bring us down. Hold on to what makes you feel. Don't let go, it's what makes you real. If the flame goes out tonight, yeah, we'll live until we die. So come out, come out, come out. Won't you turn my soul into a raging fire? Come out, come out, come out. Till we lose control into a raging fire. Into a raging fire. Come out, come out, come out. Won't you turn my soul into a raging fire? Let the world leave us behind. Let your heart be next to mine. For the flame goes out tonight. We can live until we die.
Come on, JoJo. Come on, JoJo. Here, this one. This is good.
You guys got it.
Party ladies!
One, two, three!
Come on, come on, come on!
That should be one.
You guys on a baseball game tonight?
I'm gonna try to make it, yeah.
Who are you playing?
I think we're playing Adventure.
You can beat them, right?
How they're been?
Yeah.
They're gonna be last year.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Oh my.
Are you kidding me? That's all yours, Wong.
Hey, you guys want to go see a movie? Blake just asked if you want to go see movies.
What movie? Oh, maybe.
Yeah.
The Boss.
What time?
Ooh, I think that was good.
Like in 10, 15 minutes.
Alright. Yeah, I'm down. I'm over this. So.
Yeah.
Cool.
You guys ready to go?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's head out.
Dude, this movie's gonna be sick.
Yeah, I heard it was really funny.
Better hurry up and get there before it starts.
Yeah, I got a shotgun. Ron's driving.
Oh, 911 California Highway Patrol emergency.
Assist ventilations and it's currently becoming more unresponsive.
Get a doctor in here.
pupils are fixed and dilated, unresponsive. Okay, let's get a pulse check.
No pulse.
No pulse.
Continue CPR.
Continue CPR. Can we check those wounds at all and see if the bleeding is contained?
No, not much.
Let's see. Do we have a pulse? I see cardiac scan still on the ultrasound.
4985 7 with 1 for DUI.
Hi, good evening, ma'am. I'm Officer Garrido with the California Highway Patrol. Are you Miss Phillips?
Yes.
Is your son Carson Phillips?
Yes.
May I come in, please?
Yeah.
Mr. and Miss Phillips, I'm here to give you news about your son Carson. He was involved in a traffic collision.
Is he okay? Did he get hurt?
It's with deep sorrow that we have to notify you that he passed away. No. It was a result of an accident involving a drunk driver. It was a young lady.
Oh no.
I'm sorry for your loss.
No.
You'll be able to go to the county morgue. Your son's body would be right there for you to identify him.
We, the jury, in the matter of People versus Joanne Butler, find the defendant guilty of all charges.
Today, Ms. Butler sits before you, alive, breathing, an opportunity to complete her natural life. That cannot be said of her victims. Her victims were in the very springtime of their life, as the saying goes. They had their futures before them. Those futures are gone. Their families weep for the loss of their loved ones. Every night. It's a pain that will not go away. It's a terrible heart that can never be remedied. But the only thing this court can do to bring some closure to them is by doing the right thing, and that is to impose a maximum allowable sentence under the law against Ms. Butler for her deeds in murdering two individuals. Thank you, Your Honor.
You've had the benefit of hearing the evidence of this case. You've also had an opportunity to review her probation report, Ms. Butler's probation report, Your Honor. Ms. Butler was a fantastic student at Jim Elliott with a 3.8 grade point average, loving family, loving daughter, two brothers and a sister. She played volleyball, basketball, piano. And I articulate this to Your Honor because this is not a person who woke up that day and maliciously drove her vehicle with the intent of harming anyone. She's a young woman who had a future ahead of her. And I understand the court has an opportunity to either give her 15 years to life or 30 to life. And I'm asking you, what would be the benefit to this community by taking a young girl and putting her in prison for 30 years to life? Who benefits from that? It doesn't bring the victims back. It doesn't make any of the family members feel better. It doesn't help Mr. Cozina put a notch under his belt for another victory. The reality of it is Ms. Butler can do something when she gets out if you run her sentence concurrent. By running concurrent, Your Honor, you give her a chance, a hope that she can send her message to the community of how dangerous it is to drink and drive. And I ask that you do that and take mercy upon this wonderful girl's life.
As your attorney mentioned, Ms. Butler, I did read the probation report. And when I read that probation report, it made me sad. It made me sad where I read about a girl who has a 3.8 GPA, two brothers, a sister, played sports, and had aspirations of going to Pepperdine. And by one bad choice, you have destroyed that forever. But by the same token, the victims lost their lives. They had brothers, sisters, parents, aspirations. Yet they don't have any hope of ever taking advantage of those because they did not have a choice. You did. Because of that, and the jury having found you guilty, second degree murder, two counts, I am going to impose the maximum term allowable by law and run those sentences consecutive to each other for a maximum sentence of 30 years to life. You are now remanded to the custody of the sheriff to be transported to the Department of Corrections to serve your sentence.